Hi, my name is Rita, and I'm here with Nietzsche and her 11 beautiful Rottweiler puppies that she had on New Year's Day, or they were actually born New Year's Eve and New Year's Day. They are 2 days old, just over 2 days old, and I'm just going to do a little video to show you our morning routine on, you know, through the night. They are in there, Nietzsche's nursing the puppies, and you know, it kind of gets a little messy just from, she tries to clean up after them, but they're, you know, she can't get it all. She has a lot of puppies, so I'm going to help her out, and I'm going to bring her outside, and I'm just going to show you what we do to keep the area clean. And I watched lots of videos when we were getting ready to have our first litter, and they were so helpful just to see how other people do things and whelp these puppies and raise puppies, newborn puppies. I had never done it before, so it was helpful to watch a lot of informative videos just to help get me prepared to do this and do it right. So I'm gonna bring Nietzsche outside. I have to usually bribe her with a little snack so I can get her out so I can do this. So Nietzsche, okay, so dogs are out, and I'm gonna move this up a little bit so you can kind of see what I'm doing. So I'm videoing this for myself. So the first thing that I'm gonna do is I'm going to get the puppies out. I have a little laundry basket here that I can put these guys in while I clean their bed. The puppies are, they'll settle down in a second, but you can see that it's pretty yucky in there, so I'm just gonna show you what I do to keep this area clean. Okay, so first I'm gonna take out the pick rail. Maybe move back a little bit more, so I'm gonna take the pick rail out. There's a nice little bit of poop. I'm just gonna set this to the side. I'm gonna take out this pad. So I have two. I have one underneath just to kind of help for extra protection. So I'm gonna set this aside in the laundry basket. Okay, so I had to go find my spray. So this is what I use to clean. And this is what it is. I found this online. I saw some other breeders that used it. It is safe for pets. It is called the original Lavender 256. You can see it's got a little dog on there. It's totally safe for animals, and it smells good. So, because having puppies can definitely get stinky. So, I'm just going to spray everything in there. So the puppies are still young, so it's not as bad as it can be. So it definitely over a few weeks, over the next couple weeks, it's just gonna end up getting a little bit dirtier and dirtier. But if you don't do this regularly, it'll probably get sneaky in here. So I'm just gonna keep on top of it. Wipe everything down. This is a whelping box we found on, I think we got this Amazon. Amazon's an awesome way to shop, but we found this on Amazon. It is called Easy Whelp. And they have all different sizes in it. I think you can even add to these. But they go together really nice. We used this for our last litter, the first litter that we had back in June, and it was awesome. Sets up really nice. Comes apart really easy and it stores, and we really like it. So it's around the whole area. So sometimes mom, after having puppies, will rub up against the side of this, and you notice, I notice sometimes I see smears of dried blood because she just had these puppies and she's still going to discharge a little bit for, you know, a good week after having her puppies. So I got that, and I'm gonna wipe down this pig rail. Is awesome. It's if you don't know what a pig rail is, I didn't know either until we have our first litter of puppies, and this thing is amazing because it gives the puppies somewhere to go when mom lays down in the whelping box. When she lays down with the puppies, if she, you know, puppies, yes, they scatter and they spread out. And this gives them a little area to go to so that they don't get squished. Settling down a little bit. I'm sure Nietzsche is chomping at the bit trying to get back in here. Okay. Right. So underneath my pads I didn't show you, but this goes to our heating pad. I have it underneath two of the waterproof pads, and so I have it set at over 100, but it's just a nice place for the puppies so they can stay warm. I do have a heater on here. We have to keep it super warm in here for the puppies so that, because they can't regulate their body heat. So I'm gonna go get a clean rag and I'm gonna check the puppies right before I put them back in there. Nietzsche is wanting to come back in, so I'll let her in and then I'm going to weigh the puppies do daily weighs on them. So let me go get Nietzsche. I know she wants to come in here. Good. I don't feel any hard lumps in there. I don't feel, you know, there's no mastitis going on in here. And I can also, I do this a lot with her right after she has puppies, just to make sure there's no tenderness. She's not in any pain. She's such a good girl. You're so good. Okay, I'll bring your babies back. Okay, so I'm going to start making these puppies again. I weigh them every day just to make sure that everyone is growing and gaining weight. This is our chart that we use to keep track of our puppies. All right. And so we will just go in order. So we are going to start with the red. You want to watch me? He was 16.5 yesterday, and now he is 19.2. So now we're going to do orange. Orange is another little boy. And 17.8. So he is up. He was 15.1, and now he's 17.8. Everyone is growing so good. Yellow was 14.2. And my little boy, this is another boy that we got. Oh, good. And he is 16.5. Yes, everyone is doing so good. All right, pink. We have another boy. Here is pink. Lilac. Oh, and there's Lilac. Another boy. Oops. Sometimes as they get older, it's a little bit harder to do this. 14.1. Yes. Aqua. Aqua and light blue. I'm going to start looking the same. 16.7. Puppies are gaining good. Amazing. Light blue. 18 exactly. Dark blue. White. Well, we switched. I switched white to brown, so white is brown color. It's easier to see. 14.5. And black. Black was our last puppy. This is our biggest girl. So we just started doing YouTube videos. We didn't really do very many, we did tons of videos, but I didn't post any. But we just decided that we're gonna do that now because I watched I didn't know what I was getting into when we were first gonna have Nietzsche's first litter of puppies. And so I watched so many videos just to see how they did things because I never even saw a puppy be born before. So, and I always had tons of questions, and so this is just how we do things. This is our routine. This isn't my normal job, but this is going to be my job for the next 8 weeks, raising these puppies, and I love every single minute of it, even cleaning up poop. Like, I don't even care. I love taking care of these puppies. It amazes me that 65 days ago, these puppies didn't even exist. Nietzsche was not even pregnant, and they just... 62, 63 days after mating, these puppies are fully formed and they're just incredible. They're beautiful. Nietzsche, an incredible mother. She just loves her babies. She's very attentive. She just, she just does such a good job taking care of these beautiful, beautiful puppies. But I hope that these videos can help some people if you guys are wanting to have puppies, you haven't done it before. Watch tons of videos to see how everybody does things. Find your own way and raise some beautiful, beautiful babies. They're just amazing. I love this, and if I could do this 365 days a year, I would do it because bringing these puppies into the world and helping Nietzsche every step of the way so she doesn't have to do it by herself, because 11 is a lot of puppies. Helping her do this and then finding these amazing families. Our last litter, this is our second litter. It's Nietzsche's second and last litter. She turned 3 years old on December, on Christmas Eve, and New Year's, she is retired now. She's had two litters. She had 13 last time. And this time she had 11. She's definitely done her duty, so we are going to retire her. We did keep one of her puppies from her last litter, and I can show her to you because she's in the living room, and I know she's probably still at the door. Oh, there she is. This is Dionysus. Hi, babe. Hey. Anyways, this is Dionysus from her last litter. She's come in here once. She's dying to just be in here and see what is going on in here. I know she hears these puppies. But she can't come in here yet. Nietzsche does not want her in here. Huh? Can you sit? Sit. Good girl. You are so smart. You're a good girl. I'm going to be out here in a minute. So this is Nietzsche's own special area. We changed this. This was a bedroom, but we changed it so we can do the puppies in here. And I'm just in heaven right now. So I hope this helps some people, and hit that like button and subscribe if you want to see more of our videos, and leave a comment if you want to, if you have any questions, leave them in the comments. I will try to check them. I'm super new to YouTube. Like, we just started this 2 days ago, so I'm still learning how to do YouTubes and have a YouTube channel. But I'm also on Facebook. If you want to look me up on Facebook, Rita Ann Amann. It's RitaAnnAmann. We have tons of videos and pictures of our dogs. You can see Nietzsche and Dad, who is outside, and he is in his big, huge kennel, the biggest kennel you've ever seen. But he is out there because Nietzsche just doesn't really want him in here right now. But he's gorgeous. So if you want to see more of our puppy family and who we are, you can look us up on Facebook, and you can message me on Facebook Messenger. I definitely check those more often if you have any questions. And just, if you're getting ready to have puppies, I would just definitely look more, watch tons of videos. That's what I did, and YouTube is amazing. So I hope this helped some people, and I will continue to post more videos and more things that I do to make more videos so that I can help more people answer some of the questions that they have, because you're definitely, if you're new at this, you're going to have a lot of questions. But okay, from us, have a good day.